Welcome to episode 9 of Inherit the Earth. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and last week we ended up with the dogs, and in the dogs' maze, well, with the dogs we tried to impress them, and we didn't manage that, so we ended up in the dog maze. We made our way through that. This is the other end. Now, remember last week when we weren't in the wildlands, we were in the Southlands, and the Southlands map is exactly one screen big. Now this is the Wildlands, and the Wildlands map is pretty large. Oh. This is a storm. I think you only see this once, I believe. Heavens, that storm certainly appeared quickly. It looks like a bad one, too. If the Orb of Storms was in the hands of the rightful owners, we could have predicted this. Okay, but there isn't really anything else here. You can look at the tree if you like. Wow, look at that tree. I better find shelter lest the storm turn violent and I find myself defenseless. But there isn't anything else you need to worry about here. You can just walk out the other side. But this particular storm sets up another story that we're gonna come across soon. Because one of the things, I don't know if you've noticed, but one of the things that the game is trying to do is it's trying to suggest that time is passing while Riff is on his journey. Except because this is an adventure game, that isn't really happening. So we need to go into this little village here. At last, perhaps I can find food and shelter here. Halt. Stand where you are. That should be easy enough. Where else can I stand except where I am? I'm not impressed by your clever answers. I hereby declare you my prisoner. It's about time. What? Come. I am your prisoner. Lock me up. Come find me to quarters. It's getting late. Well, what are you waiting for? My present cell awaits. By the way, what's for dinner? Oh, Riff. Oh, good lord. And this is the cat village. Halt, stand where you are. There's that phrase again. Prepare to meet the chieftess. Bow before Prawa. I am honored to stand before you. Identify yourself. I am Riff of the Fox Tribe, at your service. And she walks around and looks at you. I have seen neither you nor your kinsmen in these parts before. My village is far to the south. And what brings you here? I am on a quest to return an item that was stolen from my people. We believe that it was stolen by a raccoon that lives to the north of here. And what sort of item was stolen? A wondrous globe known as the Orb of Storms. It predicts the weather and the seasons. Such an item would be invaluable indeed. Very well. You may pass through our village unharmed. Peace be with you. My attendant will see to your comfort. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm needed elsewhere. Follow me, I will show you where you can sleep tonight. Your chieftess has a sadness about her. She's extremely concerned about the wealth of her daughter. The health of her daughter, Merp. What's wrong with her? Merp was on a hunting expedition in the mountains when a sudden thunderstorm caused her to lose her footing and fall. That was the storm that we got caught in when we came into the wildlands. Was she badly hurt? Her wounds are not bad, but it took the hunting party 3 days to return to the village. By then, the wounds have become infected. What is her condition now? She is quite weak and delirious, and not expected to last much longer. Poor Prawa. Merp is her beloved, and her hope for this tribe. We'd better get going. Please accept my gratitude for your gracious hospitality. And so we sleep, which is a good thing. Because, as the game implies, time is moving forward for Riff after a long rest. Even if that's not really the case, because it's an adventure game. So let's talk to Prawa. And see what she has to say. Well then, traveler, did you have a good night? Very comfortable indeed. I would like to repay you if possible. I understand your daughter is quite ill. Then you understand correctly. We had hoped to see an improvement in her condition, but those hopes are fading by the day. May I examine her wound? Are you a healer? No, but in my travels I encounter many different people. Any of them can provide assistance. If any of them can provide assistance, I shall do everything in my power to aid you in your plight. If you can help me in any way, you shall have my undying gratitude. Follow me. And into the tent we go. No, no, look out! The rocks are falling! Falling! Help me! Help me! She has been like this for several days. Her fevered mind keeps reliving the accident. I fear she will not be able to hold out much longer. Then I best make haste. I promise to do everything I can to find a solution. Do not lose hope. What small hope I had has been restored by you. Good luck, Griff. There isn't anything worth taking in her tent, so you may as well just leave. Let's get out of here. And get ourselves out. Oops, I don't know. Hey. Game, you're being rude. Let's get out of here. I imagine that anywhere I go will take me out, but I'm not really sure. Okay, or not. Hold on. Ah! I didn't mean to do that either. Continue playing. We're not done with episode 9 yet. Let's walk here. Actually, let's walk here. There. That's better. That spot for the valley was just, like, in a surreal and weird place. So, one thing that you'll notice that when you're in the wildland is there are these little clusters of forest clearings. Each time you go to a forest clearing, you'll meet up with this guy. He's Kylas Honeyfoot. Let's take a look at Kylas quickly. A traveling trader dressed better than most. At least the fleece holds the clothes he's wearing. So let's talk to him. Confound these shoes, shady materials. A blight on our society. What do you want? Who are you? My name is Ruth of the Fox Tribe. Kylas Honeyfoot is my name. Dry goods merchant extraordinaire is my game. Okay, so we can talk to him about the raccoon, because that's a good idea, right? I am looking for an old friend, raccoon. Perhaps you've seen him. Raccoon? Let's see now. No, I don't recall running across any raccoons lately. But if I do, I'll be sure to mention that you're looking for him. Not a good idea. Show me what you have. I'd be most interested in seeing what you have. So then, what would be a pleasure? Okay, we want the needle and thread. That's the only thing that we care about, really. So let's go and grab that. A wise choice. That will be a mere 10 credits that we don't have. 10 credits? I'm afraid I don't have that much on me. Then perhaps there's something you could barter for it. Well, I have my personal... The only thing I'm interested in is that gold ring. I'd say that was worth 10 credits. Okay, we're gonna do it because one of the cool things about Kylas is that you can meet up with him again and you can trade things back to him. So, you're indeed a shrewd businessman, young fox. And now we have the ring and we don't need to do anything else. Farewell, friend Kylas. Safe journey, my friend. And off we go. Okay, so now that we have that, the next thing that we need to talk about doing is we need to get, because One of the things that we promised was that we would go and deliver the letter, and we can do that. That's not actually terribly difficult. And it is kind of along the way with what we need to get done, so let's go ahead and do that. This is the cottage, and we're gonna look at it. The cottage door. Look at the window. I think I see someone moving around in there. Okay, so we're going to use the door. I better first make sure this is the right place. So let's talk to the door. Hello? Hello? Is anyone in there? Hello? Go away! Hospitality is underwhelming. Okay, so what we're going to do is, we don't know this is Elara's sister, but we're going to try and use the letter anyway. This is kind of funny. What happens next is kind of funny. I know. I'll slip the letter under the door. She'll read it and let me in. She is, after all, a cat. And her curiosity will surely get the better of her. Except not. Then again, maybe not. Let's get our letter again. And let's do the same thing. If at first you don't succeed, block the bottom of the door. He is not thinking this through. I seem to have missed an opening. Right, let's pick that up. And we're gonna go ahead and use the letter again. Alright, if that's the way you want to play, go ahead, try to throw the letter out now. Oops. A letter from Elara? Why, it's been forever since I heard from her. I suppose she's still involved with that sanctuary thing. She always did like that hoodoo. Yes, in fact she... But what about you? You surely didn't come all the way up here just to bring me this letter, did you? No, ma'am, I'm on a quest to... Where are my manners? Would you like something to eat? Poor thing, you must be half-starved. You come in and tell me all about yourself while I fix a little snack. Very well. And sit up straight. Young people need to watch their posture, or by the time you're my age, you'll be round-shouldered. You don't want that, do you? No, ma'am, I... Well, alright then. Go ahead, tell me a little about yourself. What are you doing here? I'm on a quest to recover the Orb of Storms, which was stolen from a sanctuary in the temple. I saw the smoke coming from the chimney, and decided to stop. Well, that's a good thing you did. Or you'd be wandering around lost for sure. Land sakes, you've had quite an adventure, haven't you? Yes. And I fear it is far from over. Now, I must try and locate a doctor for Prawa's daughter. I feel she will not last much longer. I know of no doctors in the area. However, there's some folk remedies that we've used for many years. And they work? Child, these remedies have been around a lot longer than these newfangled medicines. They work just fine. Okay, so we're going to ask her about the remedy because we need to know about that. Can you tell me about what these remedies are? Of course, I can make one for you. First, we will need some honey. Honey? I mean, to cure, not sweeten her. The honey will act as an astringent and draw out the fever. I'll give you a bowl to gather it in. Okay, excellent. We have the bowl. This will help with delirium. Once the fever is broken, the delirium will subside. And we're going to talk about the pain. What about the pain? We will put catnip leaves into the salt to help ease the pain. Also make a tea from the leaves. It will act as a sedative for her. Okay, where can I find these materials? Honeybees make their combs mostly in hollow trees. Catnip grows best in moist soil, so look around lakes and streams. Just look around you. Fortunately, I already have a needle and thread. Good. That will save us a great deal of time. And those ingredients are all I need to make the cure? Land sakes, no, child. Those are just the ingredients I don't already have. Find those ingredients and bring them back to me, and you shall have your solve. Okay, so there isn't anything else we can talk to her about. But the one thing I do want to point out that is kind of cool is that Inherit the Earth goes out of its way to show you non-stereotypical characters. This is a cat, but it's not really a cat like we know them. Also, it's an older cat because she's blind in one eye. And if she's Elara's sister, then she's probably a generation older than Riff. So that is pretty cool. What I'm going to do is... Then I best be on my way. Right. I have a life to save, friends to free from prison, and an orb to recover. All in all, a rather full schedule. Then be off with you. When you return, I'll make up the solve and send you on your way. For this, you will earn not only my gratitude, but that of the Wildcat tribe as well. I shall return as soon as possible. Okay, I'm going to end here. I know we didn't get a whole lot done, but the good thing about this is that it sets us up, because the whole idea is that we need to go and rescue Ian Ock. And the only way we can do that is by getting the cat tribe on our side. So we're going to be doing that by getting the ingredients for Prowler's, her kid. And we're going to make them all better, and that will help. So, I will see you next week when we continue this little side quest, which is actually tying into the main quest. I hope you have a great week, folks, and I will see you soon. This is Lost Wolf, episode 9 of Inherit the Earth. Have a great week, folks, and goodbye.